7, 10, 9. We have ignition sequence start. The engines are on. 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Hey everyone, Steve Walker here, the Rocket City Shaver, and I hope you enjoyed those photos of my holiday, as I've just come home yesterday for a week's vacation on a Carnival Dream cruise ship. The Carnival Dream was the name of the ship, and it was a wonderful Caribbean cruise. We were out for 7 days and seven nights. And I'll tell you what, I had a blast. So, but now I'm home, and I'm here to share with you all the things that I've done in the past week without you. So, here we go. I'm gonna go ahead and shave. I haven't shaven since Friday. Wait a minute, when did I? Saturday morning. No, Friday morning. Haven't shaven since Friday morning. So this is almost 4 days growth. Saturday, Sunday, Monday. Yeah, 3.5 days growth. So I have some shavers today. I've been drinking all week, but not this. This is the shit right here. Buffalo Trace Kentucky straight bourbon whiskey. Wonderful, wonderful stuff. Smooth. All right. I have already loaded my brush. This is the Sterling Soap Company's two-band Finest Silvertip Badger, and today's soap is Erica and Nicole's Stash Soapworks Citrus Sun. And before I went on vacation last week, I used their black pepper scent soap, and I kind of feel like I might have been a little harsh with my critique of it. I mean, it worked fine. I just thought it needed a little bit more slickness. So I'm going to use the Citrus Sun today. I think it's the same formula, and I think this is their original formula. So I'm going to give it another shot and lather it up, and let's see if I can make it better. Then maybe I just didn't lather it right or whatever, but this brush is something awesome. You guys gotta get one. It's still, I think it may not be on sale anymore. I don't know. I haven't checked the website, but if it's not, it's still a good deal, whatever it is. I mean, as long as it's not over $100, it's a good deal. Or maybe 80. I wouldn't pay more than 80 for it, but still, that's a good brush. And this is walloping up a good lather here. More water. Let's see what more water does. A lot of water. Look at there. My only critique, my only negative about your soap, Erica, was that it just needed just to be just a little bit more slick. I don't know if I was the only person that had the same feeling about it, but I this right here is a nice leather, and I got home last night and was doing some catch up on some video watching as I was relaxing after the long drive back from New Orleans after the ship docked. And so I was just relaxing and catching up on some YouTube videos, and I saw Dustin's video, and he was talking about it, and I said, well, you know, maybe I was just a little harsh, so we're going to give it another go. Now that right there, as far as lather, can't be beat. As far as lather, that can't be beat. So here we go. Here's my new razor. I did a preview video on this razor before I left. I received it the day before I left, and so I didn't have a chance to do a video on it. This is my, this is Portland Razor Company. The Strix, it's a stock razor for them. But they do make each razor handmade separately. So it is custom because I got to select the width and the tip and the scales. So it is custom, but it's also stock with options. So I chose, this is an 8/8 French point. Quarter hollow. It looks like pretty much a wedge, though. It's maybe a, I'd just say a near wedge, but it's nice. I have shaven with it already once. I did that Friday, but I didn't do it on video, and it is one hell of a shaver. So it's got the walnut scales and the newfangled design there, and I'll tell you what, this chopper is awesome. So let's get started with the shave, shall we? I strapped it up on my Gentleman's Edge by Guy Solace premium leather and fire hose strap. Let's check out the edge here. Oh yes. All right. So, I had a wonderful, wonderful vacation. The ship left New Orleans Sunday afternoon around 4 p.m. Central Time. And by midnight, we were beyond the mouth of the Mississippi River and at sea. Man, this is an awesome shaver. Man, this thing's sharp. This is the smoothest edge I've ever shaven with. Salute. So, spent our first 2 days on the ship at sea. So on day three, we ended up in forgot a spot. Seven a.m. on day three, we docked in Montego Bay, Jamaica. And spent the day in Jamaica checking things out. Not a lot to check out in Jamaica. Really? Not a lot at all. So that's what we did. We checked out Jamaica for a few hours and then we got back on the ship and waited for it to take off. And then the next morning we woke up and found ourselves in Georgetown, Grand Cayman Island. And while I was there, I sent my family, my wife and kids, shopping for big black dick while I was scuba diving. And yes, my wife did get me some big black dick. Now, scuba diving in Grand Cayman was absolutely awesome. We dove to a depth of 60 to 70 feet. And we checked out the USS Kittiwake wreck. And the USS Kittiwake was purchased by the Cayman Island government from the United States government for a grand total of $1. They bought a naval ship from the U.S. government. For one measly dollar. And what they did with it? Sunk it. Sent it straight down to the bottom. Turned into a recreational reef. Well, I'm glad they did. Because I enjoyed the hell out of diving around, swimming around with the fishes. I got swam through the entire ship, through the galley, and saw the latrine there. And then you saw the picture there at the beginning of me at the wheel of the vessel. That was awesome. Now, while it was still commissioned as an active Navy ship for the United States, the USS Kittiwake, to give you a brief history lesson on this particular ship, was the vessel, submarine, I think it's called a submarine recovery vessel, and it recovered the black box sadly when the space shuttle Challenger exploded during launch in 1986. This, the vessel that I dove through and around this past week, was the, they actually found the black box and returned it. So that was pretty cool. Again, the name of that ship was the USS Kittiwake. So, saw a shark while I was down swimming around, not around the Kittiwake. That was, just saw some cool small fish around that. But, when you go on these diving excursions off a cruise ship, it's called a two tank dive, where you you go down and you one dive with one tank of air, and you go around for about 35 minutes at a depth of usually around 60 to 80 feet. I have some touch up right here. I'm gonna on your first dive, and that was my wreck dive of the Kittiwake. And then we went on another dive, and on the second dive you get to stay under a little bit longer, but you're not as deep. You're only about 45 feet for the second dive. And on the second dive, we swam around with a reef, or around a reef, coral reef. I saw about a 5 to 6 foot nurse shark. I was about 20 feet away from him. That was awesome. That's a majestic animal right there. And then a few minutes later, a turtle, a small young turtle, I'd say he was probably about the size of a basketball hoop. And I swam, I got my buoyancy down, and I was about 4 to 5 feet above him, and I just swam around with him for about a minute or two. That was pretty cool, swimming with a turtle like that. So, I enjoyed that. And then on the next day, we went to Cozumel, Mexico. And Cozumel, Mexico is just beautiful. The best diving in the world. Jacques Cousteau says it's the best diving in the world. Petey wants in. Petey? You want in? Say hi to everyone, Petey. Look here. No? You don't like being up here? You don't want to say hi to the world? Say hi, Petey. No? Okay. Well, it'll get you down then. There you go. You're bitching about coming in, and now you don't want in here. So get out. All right. Sorry, folks. Petey was bitching. So, Cozumel, beautiful. Best diving in the world. Went down 60 feet to San Francisco Wall. The wall, it comes straight down. It's a coral reef. Comes up and then it just drops. You can't see the bottom. And that was awesome. I saw some barracuda on that dive, and some moray eel and a scorpion fish. Never touch a scorpion fish. And on the second dive, we did Paradise Reef, which just was a bunch of fingers off the reef that are just, they called them fingers, but they're just like rows of reef. That was beautiful, absolutely. About 35 to 40 feet. We got to stay on that for about 45 minutes. And on that dive, I saw a puffer fish, and the dive master was trying to get him to puff up, but couldn't piss him off enough to get him to do it. Oh, and a crab, about the same size as that turtle that I saw in Grand Cayman. This is a huge freaking crab that was backed up from underneath a ledge of a coral. Man, that thing was huge. You could eat off that thing for a week and a half. He never came out though. I hope we got pictures. My father-in-law was taking pictures. I don't know if he got good pictures of that or not. The only thing he sent me so far is where we were at the wheel of the kittiwake. So if I get more pictures, I'll put them on Facebook or something. So. All right. Then with the album block, and now for little still got tape on it where I taped it off so that it wouldn't leak in my bag in transit. Let's see if I can get it off. Here we go. Thayer's lemon witch hazel goes great with Stash Soapworks Citrus Sun, which, by the way, with the more I loaded the brush a lot more and put a lot more water in it, it was quite a bit more slick. I would still like to see it a little slicker, but it was very, very good. So I got some sun. Got a little burnt on my red neck back here. And then I got a little sun on my shins and my thighs where I was laying on the balcony. I fell asleep on the balcony, the room balcony, on the way back Saturday. More like passed out than fell asleep. Salute. Okay, so I'm going to use Success by Trump. It pairs nicely. This is a citrusy, orangey type aftershave. Yeah, and so it goes well with the Citrus Sun. Very nice. Very nice. A little bit more, because why the hell not? That's a smooth, smooth shave, folks. So, I thank each and every one of you for watching. Thanks for putting up with my vacation stories. I hope each and every one of you get to have a wonderful vacation this summer. I hope you have a good week ahead of you to start the work week. And Baba Booey to you all. Take care.